I
Who
don't know.
gave is to be burnt?
Whatever is to be burned.
What was crystal ball again?
Whatever. Sui Sho Dama.
Perfect.
Whatever.
Can you read this word up here for me?
That word is showman.
Yeoman. But you're right, men down here. Any idea what Kyomen might mean?
Showman mean like the front side of something.
Kind of. It is the face side of something. So for example, if you say the Kyomen of a table, the front side of a table would be like this side, right? This is the front side of a table, I would say. But if you say the Kyomen of a table, you're actually talking about the face of the table, which is this part, right? With the legs coming out, you know, over there. It's kind of just like the main kind of idea of that. Just like in general, it can be used for surface as well. Let's go read this example sentence.
じゃがいものひよめんだけは、
黒。
黒く、あげている、
お、焦げている。
焦げている、こ、burnt.
Right, so Kyomen in this case is like the whole outside of something, the outer layer, the epidermis. Talk about human skin.
The surface, the skin, the tomato skin dake wa,
Right.
the only the skin, only
Right.
the skin was burnt black. Kuroke,
Perfect.
koge da.
Can you read this word?
Hanari.
Close. It is the same kanji for hanasu. Hanasu. Which, see, exact same kanji. So that was a really good guess because of that. But when it has a ru after it actually becomes whole for some reason. Horu, hori nagete. Any idea what hori nageru means?
Oh, e. Hori nage is to throw. Hori is
Yes.
to release, to throw away.
Horu, yes. So horu does mean to release, but it is a releasing kind of throw. That's why it's a horu rather than hanasu, which is to just release. So you have to throw plus to throw. It basically means to toss. So it's not an aggressive aiming kind of throw. Do you know what a katamari is?
Katamari. Namari no katamari
Katamari.
yoni, like a something like a katamari.
Hi. Katamari is lump. So namari is lead. So namari no katamari no yoni means like a lump of lead.
Like a lump, like katamari,
Hi.
lump, a clot.
Can you read this word for me?
Katamari. Kogeta, burnt. Kogeta.
Nice. And how do you read this word?
Hori.
Perfect. And what does katamari mean?
A lump, a
Can you
katamari.
read this word down here?
Don't worry. Hey.
It does look like te. It might even be the same kanji of check. It's a little bit different. So this guy right here has a roof. I mean, it's a connected roof. I don't really know what it's called, but it has a little boop boop on the top versus te. This is soko. Any idea what soko means when it has this kanji? It does not mean there.
So cool. Te by itself mean about, wait, no.
Yes, it does mean bottom. Correct. Karappo no hara no soko, the bottom of the empty stomach. Can you read this
Soko.
for me?
Katamari no mama,
Perfect. What do you think
like
that
a lump.
means? Right.
A lump of flesh?
Good guess, but flesh is not on here, but I guess we're guessing by the picture of bacon over here. So mama, you know what that means?
Mama is same as before.
Same as before, yes. No change of present condition. Condition being a lump. So in the next following chapter, the Nevery is going to be looking at this thing that the main character made. And normally when you're making bacon, you cut the bacon into these little pieces, right? Or the bacon's already in those little pieces and you separate them to grill them on the pan. Well, this right here is bacon that is still a lump. It has not been separated into its little pieces.
It is still a lump.
Exactly. Can you read this word for me?
Horikonda.
Hi, horikonda. Any idea what that means? Ocha na ha o yaka no naka ni horikonda.
Kobu, right? Monikonda from kobu.
Yeah. Komu.
Komu? Komu is to go in, right?
Komu? Yes.
Konda? Kori, kori is to release.
Kori. Hi.
Drop something in.
Yeah. To throw something in. Hi.
Horu. Horu.
Can you read this word for me?
Oh. Money, horu is to throw, right?
Yes.
Horu. That there is hiyo.
Hiyo men.
Hiyo. Hiyo by itself men.
Surface. And men means face.
Men means face.
Can you read this word up here for me?
From the adjective kuroi. So kuroku.
Yep, kuroku. Perfect. So let's go read the line from the book.
Hi. Furaiban ni wa. Furaiban. Frying pan.
Furaiban. Hi.
Furaiban ni wa. Onto the frying pan.
Okay.
Pekkon ga. The bacon. Katamari no mama. Like the slices.
Is it a slice? I thought there's a mama right here. What does that mean?
Sorry, Mani. I think I misunderstood.
What does katamari mean? This is a literal word.
Lump.
I'm just giving you a visual. This means a lump. Still a lump. What is still a lump? The bacon. Should bacon be a lump?
Still a lump mean it hasn't been cut into slices
yes.
yet? Is that
this
what
bacon
it
has not been cut into slices, correct?
Okay. So mama is as before, still a lump.
Right.
Hori komare. This komare is like the stem form of masu.
Mareru form. Masu is not in this book at all, I don't think.
Komareru.
It's called passive form.
It's the stem of a passive form?
Hi.
Which mean that he komare. Komare. Hori komare meaning like...
It's the ga rather than the o here.
Is the ga. So it mean that the bacon was released.
Right, it was thrown in.
It was
thrown in where?
Into the pan.
Right.
As
what
before,
kind of state?
As a lump.
As a lump. Right. Still as a lump, the bacon was thrown into the frying pan. And?
And? Jagaimo wa hiyo men dake. The potato was only burnt. Only the skin of the potato was burnt. Kuroku.
Right.
Kuroku kogete iru.
It was burnt to what kind of level?
Black. It was black and
burnt. You know what nama means?
Nama means raw.
Perfect. So when you see say all by itself, it's read as how?
Say by itself is nama.
Yep, nama. Can you read this example sentence for me?
The example is bekon wa nama da bekon is uncooked.
Perfect. You know how to read this bird?
This part is hummingbird.
Mine right,
is like
hummingbird.
half.
It is half.
Half of a
Perfect.
plate.
Let's go read this example sentence.
This is bacon no nakawa. Nama no mamada. Bacon no nakama. Nakawa. Naka. Naka is like the middle of.
No.
It's the inside.
Hi. Yes.
Into.
Hi. The
the middle
inside of what?
Or the inside of the bacon.
So so.
The inside of the bacon is raw.
It's still raw. Hi.
Still raw. I mean, it's the outside was cooked, but the inside
that
is still
would
raw.
insinuate that. Yes, yes. You know how to read this word?
Yake.
Perfect. What does it mean?
Yake, yake. That means that yake is to be burnt.
Yeah, kind of. But how is it different than your food being burnt?
Yakete ita. So it's in the continuous past form.
Well, my difference is that we saw kokeru, right? Kokeru. Sorry. Kogeru. We just saw this word, kogeru, which means to be burnt. Kogeru. Right. We just saw that word. That is to be burnt. How is kogeru and yakeru different? Because they are very different. If you have a kokeru jagaimo no, I would say that's unedible. It is totally burnt. Now that sounds gross. What if you have a yaketa jagaimo no?
That means that it was roast.
Exactly. It was roast. It was cooked. It definitely insinuates a roast-like cooking versus like an oven-like cooking. But it doesn't like have to be. So it's to cook something. To roast.
Right. The food thing was like yakitori.
Yes. Yakitori.
Which means
that's
like
tori for bird and yake for roasting.
Grilled chicken. Yakitori.
Grilled chicken. Hi. Grilled is the other word you can use. Grilled. So it's pretty likely if you have yake that you're going to have some brown parts, some burnt parts to your food. But it should be like, that's the goal. So people like that smoky flavor. Let's go read this example, this new word.
Is it han yake?
Yeah. Han yake. What do you think it means?
Half grilled.
Perfect.
Partially.
Can you read this? Yeah. With the example sentence.
Jagaimo wa han yake da. The potato is partially grilled.
Let's go read the line from the book.
Kore de wa. Jagaimo wa han yake. Kore de wa. Meaning like this. Kore de. Ask for this, right, Money? Kore
yeah.
de wa.
With
As for
this,
this, potato is half cooked, half grilled. Bacon mo naka ga. And also the inside of the bacon is raw, as in like nama no mama da. Still raw.
Hi, still raw. Perfect.
That mean that
probably because it was a katamari. You read this word for me?
Kuchi. Hitoguchi.
Hi, hitoguchi.
Guchi.
So, hitoguchi is one mouthful. Can you read the bolded word here for me?
Bolded is kire.
Hi.
Kire imi.
Good guess. That does show up in the word imi. Right, it's the me part of imi, But it is not pronounced as imi when it's all by itself. Mi is its married reading. It another word is paste. That might be a little bit easier for you to remember.
Paste like toothpaste? Or paste like the action of sticking something with something else?
I meant taste like to stick your tongue out and lick a popsicle.
Pasting. So it's and then the action?
I wouldn't say this is an action, but the word taste in Japanese is a pretty common one to know. It is called aji.
Aji, or the taste of something.
Right.
Like it tasted gross. Yabai.
Exactly.
Like it tastes gross.
Right.
Yeah.
Yes.
So here it's kire.
So kire aji, the taste of sharpness, is being used to mean to feel how sharp something is, the sharp level of something, kireaji. So it says here, with his thumb, I double check the sharpness level of the knife. But aji normally means taste. Can you read this word for me?
Is the married reading of aji, yes?
In this case, it because mi is not being read as ken here, it is friends with benefits.
So it's both of these readings are going to be the
alone readings, yes.
The kana. Oh, so it's gonna be aji mi.
Perfect. And aji mi, which is looking and tasting, is a word to say sampling. Probably from miru to mean try something out for the first time. Let's go read this example sentence.
So this sample is bacon o ito guchi. Ajimishita. Right. I tasted in one map in one gulp.
Hi, perfect. And my pronunciation is incorrect. It's hitokuchi, which was the first way you read it. Not guchi. I don't know why guchi would just easy to say. Yeah, so hitokuchi. No rennaku.
In one bite,
yes. So I take one bite of the bacon to sample it. So hitoguchi could mean like to eat something in one bite. That's 100% possible. But the ajimi, which means to sample, insinuates that the hitoguchi is more like a small mouthful morsel than a larger one or something. So hitoguchi just means one bite. And context lets you know whether or not one bite ate the whole thing. Or here it's a teeny tiny bite because it's being... The verb is ajimishita, to take a little sample. So he's just saying, he basically is saying, I took one sample. Or a bite is what we say in English.
Ajimishita. Yeah. I tasted it.
Exactly. I tasted it. So in English, you'd say, I took a bite out of the bacon, right? That makes sense. You didn't eat the whole bacon versus I ate the bacon in a bite, right? We both use a bite to mean one bite. But the sentence, how it's ordered, gives us two totally different ideas than I ate the bacon in a bite and I took a bite of bacon. They're very similar. Both have a bite, which means a single one bite. But the sentences tells us two very different ideas. Ate the bacon in one bite, you know, that nah, 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 becomes, you know, versus the opposite is a smaller idea. Do you know what a hocho is?
Hocho. A wrapping.
Good guess. Hocho is a knife, specifically a kitchen knife. One of those nice bad boys for cutting potatoes. Ended with cho. Do you know what it started with?
Cho. Ended with cho. Started with ho.
Hi, ho. Is it a long hole or a short hole?
I think it's a long one.
It is a long hole. Hocho. Which is what is a hocho?
It's a kitchen knife.
Perfect. Let's go read this example sentence.
Hocho no kire aji o. I test the sharpness.
Hai. Tashikameta.
Tashikameta.
Sharpness of what?
I confirm the sharpness of the kitchen knife.
Perfect. What is the te form of this word? To cut?
Te form of to cut. Kire. Kiru. Te form. Kire.
Yeah. Kite. Hai. It's like that'll stop. Perfect. So this word started with hole. What did it end with?
Start with ho and cho.
Hi, ho cho.
Well,
perfect.
Cho by itself, you happen to know what it means? It looks like the nail.
Normally, it means, like, I feel like it's normally used to mean like a district. But, cho on its own is a counter for long and narrow things.
It's a counter.
Or, the second meaning is that it can mean like the fourth class ranking of something.
Hi.
Yeah, it's a counter.
Hole by itself is like a wrapping thing, right?
No, it's very similar kanji of tutu. Tutu. Right there. Oh wait, you're right. It is the wrapping kanji.
The long thing that wraps?
Yeah. The kitchen knife. Pretty random. Oh, I'm counting long wrapping things.
Very. But that was the meaning earlier. I'm looking.
But yeah. Oh, show me its kitchen knife.
Oh.
Well, let's go. Well, apparently in the old days it used to mean cooking and food, so. Might have been some kind of weird passing for things.
In the old vocabulary, it just means cooking.
Yeah.
That's interesting. The raven is jagaimo o hocho de kita. I cut the potato using the kitchen knife.
Perfect.
No, I cut the potato. Yaki na o jagaimo o hocho de kita. I cut with the kitchen knife a potato.
Yes, exactly. Let's go read this new word.
Yaki naosu.
Perfect. Do you know what naosu does to verbs?
Naosu is to repeat.
Exactly, to redo something, yakinaosu, to re-cook. The idea is that you're cooking something again in a, like, fixing it kind of way. So it's not like I cook someone breakfast and someone says, I want seconds, and you cook again. That's totally different. This is normally an item that has been cooked, but you have to re-cook it because it wasn't cooked all the way or something, or was cooked wrong, or the cooking action was interrupted. Can you read this phrase for me? Yes.
The term for similar sounding word are automopedia.
Automanopedia are sound words, yes.
Oh,
but not similar words. I think you're thinking about homophones.
So,
are similar
sound
words.
word is automopedia.
Yeah.
Automopedia are sound words.
Hi.
Homophones are words that sound the same but have different
Yes.
meanings.
Yes.
So this is homophone. The naosu is homophone with to govern a city.
Yeah,
Like the
nauru.
Duchess governs
Yes,
the
nauru
district.
can be to govern or to heal.
Wait, nauru or naosu?
Nauru. But the nauru and naosu are the transitive and transitive pairs.
Oh. Naosu is the transitive version. The Dutch is govern, like
Well, they're They're doing. I was talking about fixing.
Fixing, but it can also mean governing, right?
Yeah.
Because I saw this suit before in one of the sentences.
Yes, you did. To govern is a word that we see here. I can't find it Googling it for some reason. So I know I'm pronouncing it wrong. Okay. Osamu is a govern. Okay.
Osamu is the governor.
Osamu.
But they use the same kanji here. What's that about?
Yeah.
Osamu.
Osamu. Now what is now sit. So now sit and naoru both mean to fix something. If you break a leg and you want to fix your leg, the leg will be now naotad. Will be now stud. But osameru is to govern. It can also mean to subdue something. Osameru or osamu. So.
Osamu is the governor. Oh, so to fix and to governs.
Yeah.
Osamu. This here is to repeat. Osu.
So you want to think about it as fixing something. It was not yakied correctly before, so now we have to fix it. How would we make it if something was not correctly cooked? How would you fix it so that it would be correctly cooked? What would you do?
You repeat. You know, so
Yes.
I get it.
That's what it's telling you. That's why it's not something else. Because
It's the
it's
same
specifically
word.
saying to do it again, but because you need to fix it.
Is not a homophone. Is the single word with different kanji used in different contexts. It meant
Yeah,
the
this is
same.
just the second. It's kind of like how iru means to exist, but yondeiru means to be reading. It's basically saying to exist right now, right? Iru, to exist right now at the act of reading. And it's the same with komu means to cram into something. And when you add it to a word like aruku, which become aruki komu, which is not something we say. I don't know why. Oh, nigi komu. Whatever. Another word with komu would mean going into with that verb. The komu could say inside meaning to it, rather than meaning literally to crab. It's very common for the second verb to have a slightly looser, like a slightly different connotation for when you see it.
Right.
But yeah,
Kage
to
gomu to throw in.
yes, kagik, hori komu to throw in. Let's go read this example sentence.
This the fireplace.
Hi.
I'm blanking out, Moni.
Dan roll.
Danro. Danro. What is it? Danro ni ho ga. Not ho. Hi ga. Aka aka to. This is a homo automopedia. Aka aka. Red. Aka aka to. This is the action meaning burnt, but not the koget.
So kogeru is to be burnt. Ya geru is to cook food in a way that may allow for reburning. However, here, the one doing the action here is the heat, right? Versus kogeru, the thing that'd be koketad, right? You'd have a koketa mono, a thing that has been burnt. Yakeru would be a yaketa. Well, no, a thing that has been cooked. But the word over here, this eta, would be he. Because he's are the one that do this verb. Right? This is something that the fire does. It is done to the fire. It is not something done to food. Any idea what it means?
The fire.
What does fire do?
Fire flaming.
Yes, the fire is flaming. That's exactly what this is saying. Flaming, another word you can use is blaze. The fire blazes a brilliant red in the fireplace. Could be how you could translate this.
Danro. Danro.
So, right. Do you have a guess how to read this? This is moeru.
Moeru.
Hai, moeru. Danro ni hii ga aka aka to moeru. Can you read this word for me?
Sameru, to kill. Moeru, to burn.
Moeru, to blaze. Yakeru, to cook. Kogeru, to burn. Hai.
Moeru, moeru, to burn.
To blaze.
Blade.
I don't think fire burns. I mean, it burns other things, but fire itself. I mean, it depends how scientifically you're getting, but it's not what the word is trying to get to.
Hi.
The fire burns. I guess you would say the fire burns in the fireplace. I guess we do say that in English. There's separate words in Japanese for that idea.
But I understand what you mean. It's not doing the action to something else. It's not causing something else to burn.
Yeah,
Burning
exactly.
Something else. Is blazing
Yes.
Itself.
Yes.
It's flaming in itself. Which is correct. Hi.
Hi.
This word is tori, to take.
Hi.
Ageru, to take up.
Exactly. And to take up has the idea of to confiscate something. Probably because it mostly was used when you have like a little kid and they have an item and the parent goes, ah! So they toru, they take it, and they have to, and they, it goes upwards because the kid's small, so that's why it gets confiscated that way. So that's probably like where it was first like made, but it just means to take away or, like I said, to confiscate. Can't touch that no more, little kid. Do you want to read this word?
Toru, tori.
Perfect. How about this one?
Cho is the second reading.
Yeah, the
the
second one is
first
cho.
character is ho, hojo.
Perfect. And what is a ho cho?
It's a kitchen knife.
Perfect. So let's go read the line from the book.
I get it. Cho here literally mean an instrument of cutting. It doesn't mean a district here.
Yes.
Getting it. Okay. It used to be a different kanji. And they got lazy and they replaced it with this simplified version. That's what I'm guessing.
It's possible.
It cuts the thing that covers something out. It used to cut. Wakata. Jagaimo o hitokuchi ajimi shite kara. While I took a bite of the jagaimo, a frying pan oh hitori tori age. I take up, which means I take a frying pan.
From who? From the ground?
Yes, I took possession of it. I
took
tori
possession,
age.
Yes. It the idea with the ageru, rather than meaning literally going up. The idea is that he's taking this from someone. Who had the frying pan earlier in the book? Do you know?
Oh, it was Khan who had it before.
Khan had the frying pan. So he takes the frying pan from Khan. So, shite kara. You did not translate that right. It does not mean while. It is not nagara.
From.
It does mean from, yes. So from doing that. So in English, we normally would say after. So after taking a little taste, taking a single bite out of a tasty bite out of the potatoes, I confiscate the frying pan. And what does Neveri do?
How do we know Neveri is the actor here?
So the reason why we know is that this book is always written in the first person. And we are currently, it's been a while, but we are currently in the diary entries rather than the normal novel entries. In the normal novel entries, everything is about Khan. Khan is the one saying I. So in the diary entries, we know Neveri is the one doing everything. He is the I. So it's been a bit since we went like, who's the protagonist right now? But that's what it is. I know this is Neveri, because in the previous line, when we first started this, we had the word Kozo. Kozo ga rori shiteita, which was the boy is cooking. So I know, oh, can't be Khan's POV. We must be doing Neveri's POV, because those are the two POVs you can pick from, Khan's or Neveri's. So that's why I know Neveri is the one who took a bite out of the jagaimono and took the frying pan.
Wakatta. So here is jagaimono o hitokuchi ajimi shite kara, after I took a taste with a bite out of the potato, frying pan o tori age, I take possession of the frying pan, jagaimo mo bacon mo tori dashi. I also take the potato and I take the bacon as well.
Hi, right, where do you take it to? What is this dasu telling us?
Tori, I take dashi from dasu. I take them out of, yes, what? Guessing
the frying pan. Kind of
frying pan.
Yes. The last sentence, we found out that inside the frying pan, there was potatoes and there was bacon. The bacon was in a lump, and I think it was still raw or something. And the jagaimo no, just the outside of it, was just burnt.
Jagaimo no,
so, because he's taking away the frying pan, the next thing he does is takes these two things out of that frying pan. The frying pan is now empty. What does he do next?
Dashi, money from dasu.
Yes, that is correct.
That means it's going out of something. It was originally, yes, in something, now it's out of something.
Yes.
Dasu. To take it out. Okay. So now.
He made it appear when it was inside of something else.
Now is hojo de kite.
Hojo de.
The kitchen knife. I cut.
What do you think he cuts? This is contextual.
I'm guessing he cuts the bacon here.
So. And probably the potatoes as well. But specifically the bacon is what really needs to be cut. Right. He probably does not cut the frying pan.
Wakatta. All
right. And what does he do next?
Next, he kichinto. Is this another automopedia?
Sure, it's definitely an adverb. It means 100%. That's how I'm gonna translate that for now. To do the job as it should be done.
きちんと.
To do the job in the way it should be done.
きちんと is to do it as it should.
Yeah.
Hmm.
It's like chanto, right? Chanto, kichinto. Same idea. It's official definition is properly, accurately, exactly, precisely, neatly, orderly. Kichinto.
Kichinto. Accurately. Mm. So properly or accurately, higa toru made. Toru made just mean like straight.
Well, why don't you go to the verb first?
Hiru made. Hiru made. Yakinaoshita.
Hi. So he is yakinaosuing. What does that mean?
He recooked.
What is he recooking?
He's cooking the bacon by contact.
So. Perfect. And in what kind of way is he recooking it?
So made is now acting as an adverb, Monnie?
It always is an adverb.
It always is an adverb, but it marks the
Yeah,
destination, right?
the door is open until it closes.
So this is a time phrase?
Yeah. But in this context, it's not a time phrase. I mean, because it's modifying an action. But Monde is always an adverb.
So he
In
cooks.
Japanese, time phrases are adverbs.
Higatoru made. I cook it until.
Hi.
Made here had the connotation of until. Like it also had the time sense that there's some time gone by and it reaches a certain state after a certain amount of time. So it's tori, it's all the way through.
Hi.
Cook it until it's all the way cooked. Properly cook.
Yeah, but what is going all the way through the bacon in order to cook it?
The flame, the higa
So.
toru made. Okay, until the heat of the flame or the flame itself, it's all the way through.
Exactly. Perfect. Because if the heat can't get inside the bacon's ain't going to cook.
Right, so the heat here is like the heat itself, the flame
Yes.
itself. In the bacon.
Perfect. So now I'm going to make you redo the whole sentence. You don't have to say it in Japanese, but you have to translate the whole sentence.
Hi. The whole sentence is I took a taste of the tomato potato. Afterward, I take the frying pan.
From who?
I take the frying pan away from Kong. I also take the potato. And the bacon out of what was not insinuated, he just say I took it out. Then with a knife I cut and I recook the I'm guessing I recook them,
Yeah,
the thing
we
that
could
I
get
took out,
them. Right.
all the way through with the flame
Perfect.
or by
Nice.
the flame cook all the way through.
Literally just as the flame goes till the flame goes all the way through it, but it's meaning until it's fully cooked with the flame going through there. Can you read this word?
Hori.
Perfect. How about this one?
Ryori.
Hi. How about this one?
Kogete. Money to clarify. Is it Ryori or is it just Ryo?
It is Ryo for the first kanji and then Ri for the second kanji. Ryo. So the tongue spinny thing you're trying to do is correct. Ryo. Ryo.
It is a long sound. It had an extra. It's a long sound, basically. It's not
Yes.
Ryo. Ryo.
Yeah, you don't really see ryo short very often. I don't really know why, if there's a reel for that or something.
Ryo,
Almost
ryo.
always it'll be long.
Ryo,
I wonder if
like
there's anything that has a small
dish.
reel. Like, I feel like this is a couple small shows in Japanese, but it's more common if you're having the big kanji with the little kanji that you will have some kind of extender going after it, like you. I guess not like sha. Like sha will be short. So that said, yeah, I don't
I
think is
felt a
common,
little.
then it wouldn't have. Yeah.
I felt a little sad for Kane. I felt like
He was
he was kind of.
trying.
He
I
was
don't think
kind
Khan
of.
cares. He's like, yay, the food's being cooked.
He feels to me like a happy child who was abandoned.
Yeah.
He doesn't know how to take care of himself. He doesn't know how to cook. He
Can't
doesn't have
even
good
cook his
clothing.
bacon.
This poor
Poor,
boy.
poor Khan. What's the stem form of this word?
Is this is to create, to make, which is scooter.
Yes. Hi.
Te form would be scoot that with a glottal stop.
Perfect.
Scoot
Nice. What's stem form?
Stem form. Sorry, not the te
Hi.
form. Stem form is scooty.
Perfect. What do you think tsukurikata means?
The way of making something. The method.
Perfect. What's this bolded word up here?
Oh, I know this.
教える。To teach. So, tsukuri what?
Tsukuri kata.
Perfect. The way of cooking. Do you know what tazuneru means?
Was that the... Okay, so the other one with nasu. This one is tazu. Tazune. Tazuneru?
Tazuneru, hai.
Tazuneru?
Hmm.
To ask question, I keep forgetting.
It is to ask a question. Perfect. Let's go read the line from the book.
Kozo ga muffin no tsukuri kata o tazuneru no de. No de here is a conjugation of contrasting. It's a contrasting particle.
If you really want to know what it is de, right? Which is te form of da, right? Te form of da, which makes it into the tool, right? With this, which is the nounifying this whole entire thing. It's restating it into one, right? So this right here is the tool used in order to do oshieru, right? Like the knife is the tool used in order to kill someone. So in this case, we translate this normally as since, because that flows better in English.
With this, okay. So clause one allowed for clause two to exist.
Hi.
It's an explanation clause. It's an explanation. Yeah. Like de is an instrument, and here it acts as an by means of, which is because of. Because of
that's
this.
Also why, you know, no ni, you'll see, is normally in English translated as even though, right? But that's the same thing as this one, but it's ni for adverbial. So it tends to be an even though kind of feeling, but it doesn't have to be, right? Because it's not actually literally it's not actually literally even though. So this is not actually literally since, but since is the best way to translate it, like 90% of the time.
Hi. So here it says that the boy asked.
Hi.
Since the boy asked for how to make the muffin.
Hi.
I teach him.
Exactly, I teach him. And it's funny he uses yaru's rather than ageru. Kind of rude. So. Taburu, to eat. How can you turn this into cannot eat, which is the potential negative form? I can't eat.
Negative had the nai ending. So
right.
Taberarenai.
Hi. Perfect. Taberarenai. Cannot eat. Perfect. So we just read this sentence right here, which is kozo no muffin no tsukuri kata o tazuneru no de. 教えてやった. So this is continuing kind of based off of that. Remember, he's writing in his diary. Never he is. So let's go read the actual line, which is over here.
Hi, it's shikashi in kyo wa no. But today, jagaimo no yona.
I really would recommend reading the whole sentence before translating things, because things start sounding weird when you do parts of it.
Wakata.
But today. 今日のジャガイモ. But today.
しかし, but okay. 今日のジャガイモのようなできならば. ならば is while I'm doing the action.
Nagara is while doing. Naraba is just nara. He never uses naraba, which is a little bit older, but doesn't particularly have a different meaning. It's still if slash when, person specific.
Nara.
So here it's if con.
I see. If deki from dekiru.
Yes.
To be able
in this
to.
Case, yeah. I would translate it as done in this context. But it is the dekiru to be able to.
Jogaimo no yona dekiru. If it's able to be the top. If he can do the potato.
If it's done in a way that is like what?
Like the potato. So if he gonna.
Which potato?
The burnt one.
Yes, today's potato. Kyō no jagaimo no. That's why I was making fun because you were putting today's, but like the today's goes over there. So it's but if it's done like today's potato. So the but is down here where the clause middle thing is in the middle, right? It doesn't go randomly. The other things don't go randomly with it. That's why it's always good to continue until you reach a verb, which in this case, deki is basically the verb. It's the nounification of deku, which basically means like quality, I guess, of something. So I just will say done. So if it's done, if it's been done, dekita, right? If someone says, ah, dekita, after they cook, right? Because it's not, it's like, I can do it. It just means it's done. Dekidu is to be able, but it also can mean done, right? Or you might see it to say, oh, the building is made from bricks, right? Brick de dekidu, right? So it's more like done in this context. So if it is done in a way like the potatoes of today, what does he say? Think.
You say the totemo. Totemo taberare mai.
Perfect. So mai is basically the same as nai. The difference is that mai is more like shall rather than is. So nai is not, so shall becomes shall not. Shan't.
What about totemo, Bonnie?
What do you totemo? You don't know totemo?
I don't remember.
Totemo means very. It? Yes.
Very.
Totemo, totemo.
Totemo, totemo, very. It's an adverb.
Yes.
Totemo. Very. So, very not eatable.
Yes.
Not only will it not be eatable, but it would very not.
Yep. However, if it's like the potatoes he made today, then it shall not be edible. It shall not be edible at all.
Right.
Yeah.
Because he asked.
So the shall not, because we're doing future tense. Might.
So the previous sentence was, Khan asked for how to grill he asked for how to make the muffin. He asked for how to make the muffin and... Nevery is thinking if it's like the potato, then it also would not be good.
Yeah, you won't be able to eat it at all. It's gonna be disgusting. Can you read this word for me?
Meat. So the kana reading and then also the kana reading for the second word, which mean to continue. It's not susumu, so it's running away.
That word right there is to send, like to send something in the mail.
Sukuku? Suguru?
No, I was trying to do the word to continue, which is tsutsugu, but it wasn't showing up. Oh, because I was doing
tsutsugu.
I can't write well. It's a goo. Tsutsugu. Tsutsugu? Oh, tsutsugu.
Suzu.
It's like everything is wrong when you have to write it on a sentence. Suzuku is to continue, and it's not popping up.
Suzuku, not Suzuku.
There it is. You can see the kanji, it's very different.
To send away?
Yes, to send away is the kanji over on this corner. That is okuru. Okuru. Something you okuru would be a tegami. It is something you put to somebody else to send, right?
Tsuzuku, to send away, to send.
Yeah, okuru. No, tsuzuku is to continue. That's what you thought the word was. You said, oh, is that continue? And I was like, no, continue has this kanji.
It's not continue, it's okuru.
It's okuru, yes. And what does okuru mean? To send, yes. So, mi okuru means to send your eyes, which means to see off.
To see someone off.
Exactly.
はい。
How do you read this word? Oops.
送る。
はい、送る。What's the stem form?
Stem is 送り。
Perfect. Can you read the bolded phrase for me?
The store is yeast. It's not, yeah. Yeah, it's not the reading.
Starts
the
with a
reading.
meat.
Miten.
Mise.
Mise.
Ten is the married reading.
Mise ga. To clump together?
Hi, to gather together, yeah. To be gathered. It does have a
suit.
T in it, but it doesn't start with a T.
Atsumari?
Hi, Atsumari from Atsumaru. Mise ga Atsumaru. The streets are gathered together. Do you know how to read this word here? From Akebo no what?
Akebono meaning the dawn.
Hi.
And then district, this is not cho, but te.
It's not te either. Te means mansion.
This is guy.
Hi, guy for district. Perfect. What's
guy.
this word?
Cover.
Yeah, komu.
To go in, to be put in.
Yeah, what's the volitional form of that?
Relational, as in like.
I volunteer for tribute. It means I'm gonna do it.
I'm gonna do it. It's komu. Komo.
Hi, komo. Perfect.
I volunteer.
Yeah. So can you read this word for me?
Kori.
Oku.
Oku. Okuri komu. Okuri
Perfect.
komu.
So okori komu means to send in, like to send someone in to do something. So the thing you're sending is going inwards. Like send in the infantry. How do you read this word?
Atsumaru.
Perfect. How about this one?
That one would be show.
This is meshi tsukai.
Meshi.
Meshi tsukai. What is a meshi tsukai?
Meshi tsukai is a servant.
Perfect. And how do you read this word?
Kozo.
Hi. So let's go read the line from the book. This will be our last line of the day.
Hi, Moni. Ashita wa tomorrow. Maho majutsushi taji ga atsumaru hi da. The day of the gathering of the magician. Or the magician will gather. The day when the magician gathered.
What is the subject of the first sentence?
The subject is the magicians.
Good guess. This is a relative clause. So this actually is the subject, not of the sentence, but of this clause right here. Who's describing the noun?
The
He.
subject of the clause. So we are describing a stop. So we're saying
Hi.
Tomorrow is the day.
Yep, tomorrow is the day. Which day?
Where? The day which the magicians gather. Or will
Perfect.
gather. This is the future tense of
Yes.
Atsumaru. We know it's future because Ashita is the modifier.
So.
Or is the subject here.
Is the context, yes. Dictionary form either means future or habitual tense. And you just have to use context to tell you which it is. Ashita tells us, must be future.
Wakatta. And then second sentence. Meskai no kozo o. So meskai describe the kozo.
Hi.
The boy who is the servant.
Yes.
The servant boy. Supai to shite.
So to shite, not to suru.
To suru is as.
Yes.
In the position of.
Yep.
So he will be sent in as a spy.
Yep.
As a spy. Okuri
yeah.
komu komo I shall.
Yep. I shall send in the boy as a spy. That's exactly what it says. Things are getting exciting.
Funny, Meshi Sky. Sky is the Sukai. Right? Is the word to utilize.
Yes, from scout. Yes, to use. And it is in stem form for sky. You don't necessarily need the E, but this does have the E here. But that's just the nanification of the verb scout. Making it into stem form becomes sky.
But then the word meshi.
Hi, meshi.
You know what meshi means?
It's kind of like the back, but it means summon. It's called
to summon. To summon someone.
So meshi sky is to summon and use. So that's a servant. The servant is someone you say, come here! And then you make them do something, you use them. So Meshit summon. Meshit sky.
Gotta.
Any other questions before we go?